Hey everybody, this is Mother Spring Chicken. The latest news today is look for new regulations. Are you ready for this? On gold, on buying and selling gold. Can you believe that? Oh my gosh. Of course, it's to protect the consumer interest. Well, for now, we're going to bring Oldecam on with comments on the headlines of today.
And it's all over for the Republicans.
Well, yeah, if you listen to the news today, I mean, my God, the market is just going off the scale over the thought of brand new taxes, more regulation, the fact that gold is going to be regulated, and the consumer interest, gold is going to be taken off the selling block by the average person because the Republicans are forcing people to sell their gold to pay their bills, and they just want to protect the consumers by passing new legislation in order to prove, actually, they don't have, the President of the United States has the ability, truly by executive order, to restrict the sale of gold because in reality there is a law on the books that says it's illegal to possess and sell gold without government permits, and since he's in charge of the government, he can, by executive order, just reinstate it again.
Mm-hmm. And Obama's to face a tough crowd in the State of the Union address.
Well, you know, they figure that the Republicans are going to be dancing on the top of tables, and they're going to be cheering everything he says. Well, actually, Boehner and 47 other Republicans that are preparing to join the Democratic Party. I think that Boehner actually thinks he's going to be the Speaker of the House when they turns the party over to the Democrats. That's not going to happen.
Mm-hmm. And California's Hispanic population projected to outnumber white in 2014.
Yeah, but then...
I thought they already did.
Well, no, they're going to actually, under the president, they're going to start counting them. Remember the ones that are illegally voting, they're going to start counting them as actually being citizens of the state, which they're not. Remember in California, California's sanctuary state, where you can, everybody from Tijuana can come over to the state of California and work off the social welfare system in our state because the state has now decided that we're going to welcome every, BS Bill said to tell you something. In California, they're planning an intensive campaign to lure businesses from Texas and other states with all of the benefits that we have to offer. We've got a welfare system that's bigger than anybody else's. We have a debt that's bigger than anybody else's. We've just raised the taxes to do business in the state of California. You now have to pay a special tax for everyone you hire. And these are the incentives to come to California, and they expect to take business from all the states.
Mm-hmm. And the U.S. backs off goal of 1 million electric cars by 2015.
Well, because the federal government can only buy so many cars. Plus, the batteries don't work because they're now finding out. Obama's lithium battery company was sold to China. And now we're getting Chinese batteries to put in our military equipment and everything else. Remember, he let the Humvee go to China, which is a military vehicle. He's letting all the companies that produce military equipment be sold to China. You think they're going to sell us anything that works?
Mm-hmm.
That would be stupid.
And Rice says citizenship a vexing issue in immigration reform.
They're not going to get there. They're going to get, they figure the children that were brought here are going to get first in line. The parents are never going to be allowed. That's the way that's going to work because the parents could have done something if they'd have wanted to do something. And the children don't want to be citizens. I mean, you want to go to a hostile community? Go to an area where young Hispanics that they do not consider themselves to be part of the United States. They consider this to be part of Mexico. And I can go in that area, but it is not safe for armed police to go into those areas at night.
And Democrats offer pre-buttal to Marco Rubio's rebuttal of Obama's State of the Union.
I know. They're telling you, Republicans want to gut this program. Republicans want to gut that program. Oh, you know what BS just said? Sequester was created by the Democrats, not by the Republicans. What happened was that Obama backed himself into a corner, and when Obama is not on a teleprompter, somebody's writing it, he says stupid things. Now he's saying... He also told people, it will never happen. I promise you before this election, sequester will never happen. It's getting ready to happen because the Republicans, he got his tax increase. He's not getting more tax increases. He's not going to take the subsidies from oil and give it to wind industry because wind has never been more expensive than it. They said the more involvement of the government, BS tells it to tell you something. We went to an event where they were telling people, I can't afford this. And the guy said, don't worry about it. You don't have to pay for it. The president is guaranteeing the sales. That's what they were telling people at a wind event. The president is guaranteed, so just buy it and we'll deliver it. And we're not even going to charge you.
Venezuelan opposition cracks could help Chavez's allies.
I don't see how, because Chavez hasn't even been seen in 2 months, which means he's really in bad shape. They don't like the guy that's his second in command. When Chavez goes, they use, generally what happens is, they're a dictator, unless it's somebody that knocks off the dictator, is almost always followed by a democracy, so the democracy could pay the bills, and then when they've paid the bills, they overthrow the democracy again.
NFL's Goodell, no brain damage cover up in football.
Okay, I played football before they had hard helmets, folks. I mean, they had helmets, but they were not the things they do today. And I guarantee you, I was not a small person. I was a 240-pound receiver. Mm-hmm. I was a big person. If I actually hit somebody, they knew they were hit. And so it's no difference today. You have 340-pound men hitting 310-pound men, mm-hmm. but they figured out how we're going to stop it. We're going to tear up every football stadium in the United States and rebuild it to the configuration of the Canadian mm-hmm. Football League. But Canada doesn't have as many injuries as they do. But Canada scores a heck of a lot more games because their fields are wider and longer, which means it gives people more. Okay, you figure, here's what you got a 140-yard field, you got a 350-pound lineman going 100 yards. They're going to have people die of heart attacks because our linemen are not going to give up like they do in Canada.
Mm-hmm. And Obama may issue order Wednesday on defense against cyber attack sources.
Well, for the good of the country, he's got to take control of the internet. For the good, even though Congress will not give him the authority under executive order, they think that as early as tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time, he's going to seize control of the internet in this nation. Isn't that great?
Uh-huh.
But it's done for your interest, though.
For your protection.
Remember,
of course.
Obama lost 8 million people that supported him because they no longer were able to afford the internet. So now he's going to seize the internet to take it away from the other people.
South Sudan accuses Sudan of bombing and Khartoum denies.
Oh, they're always, the Sudan has been a fight. Basically, the Muslims really don't like the Sudan because it's just, every few years they overthrow whoever the leader and somebody else takes control. It's been a battleground since the days of the Crimean War.
Loggerheads over oil territory and other disputes and came close to war in April.
Yeah, they're fighting. What happens is that it's a war, not a war as you might expect. It's basically, it's a war between Canada and the United States over the fact is we can sell our oil to anywhere we want to. If you don't want it here, we're going to sell it to the Chinese. And Obama says, you can't sell it to the Chinese, it's our oil. No, it's Canadian oil, and he won't allow the pipeline that's being built to be hooked up to Canada. So, you know, it's for all practical purposes, it is a war, but not shooting war. It's an economic war.
What school foods are in and what foods are out?
Okay, if Michelle Obama approves of it, it's in. If she doesn't approve of it, it's out because she's the one that decides what's good for you. I like the guy last night. One said she's got a butt that looks like an express train, running by, but she will tell you what you can eat. She said, you don't get that rear end of hers unless you're eating something.
I know. It's like lead by example.
Well, they said that Obama's personal parties, they serve food that would kill a bull elephant at his events. There's so many calories. There's so many of this. Well, there's a difference between us. We're responsible. And those people that take their children to McDonald's aren't. It's basically you're insulting the public. Mm-hmm. That's what she continues to say. We are responsible. We know when to stop. No, they don't know when to stop. You got to see the food that these people chow down on.
And Florida's new business logo, sexist critics say.
Okay, they got a tie in an ad. I'm going to explain something very important. How many women, business women, that dress up wear ties?
I know.
The men do. They wear ties to show that they are equal. That's the whole big deal with the women business person.
A tie represents business.
That's right. A business that treats business in a casual dress manner isn't really running a good business. Mm. No matter what. Okay. Well, These guys are making $100 billion a year, and they're losing it all too, folks. Mm-hmm. Look at the stock market, see their stocks tanking.
And a Monty Bubbleism from the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom.
Well, this one's come home to roost, but that's not trust, but verify.